Did you know that the eyes are the gateway to the soul? I have helped thousands of students create soulful portraits of their pet, all because of one thing.
In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of the magic of the value scale and how it's going to bring your painting to life. This skill is something that evolves and gets more comfortable the more that you paint. You're going to be building on this skill in every painting you do from here on out. In the last few videos, I covered how you can get started right now by picking your favorite pet photo and how you're going to impress yourself with this new skill set that you're going to be learning. And I also covered why the Lovejoy method will bring out the creativity in you that others have led you to believe that you don't have. I truly believe and know that you are more creative than you give yourself credit for. If you missed those videos, please make sure you go back and watch them so you can get the full picture of what you're going to be kind of getting into as you paint your pet. Now, I'm really excited to tell you about my simple approach to learning how to paint and utilizing a foundational art skill, the value scale. The value scale is the way that artists show depth, and it's basically the way that you are a magician creating a 3D image, a 3D illusion on a flat 2D surface. And you're going to learn a lot more about it in the course. So simply stated, the value scale is all your range of shades that you're going to see, with black being the darkest and white being the lightest, and then all the shades in between. We are going to be starting with the darkest shade first and working towards the lightest color. And you're going to witness your canvas and your pet come to life. It's very exciting. When you're looking at your pet photos, as you're going through and finding which ones you want to paint with, I want you to start to notice the darkest section of their fur. If they have brown fur, I want you to notice the darkest brown area. If they have black fur, I want you to notice the darkest area. If they have white fur, I want you to start noticing maybe a medium or a light gray fur. I've had many students that have emailed me after class saying that they, you know, went out swimming and they started noticing the shadows on the water, and they started noticing the highlights on the water. Or when they looked in their pet's eyes, they started noticing the catch light. So once you get into painting, it is going to change the way that you look at the world. And the value scale is a great way to kind of get started with that process. In my Paint Your Pet course, we will go over this in more detail. I will also have specific color demos to match your pet's fur and help you along the process. You are learning a core foundational art skill, and you're going to be taking these skills into all your future creative projects. It's very exciting. And not only are you gonna love your pet even more and notice little nuances and just all the unique things that make your pet so special, you're gonna realize the stress relieving benefits in the process of painting. And that is truly one of the best parts about the painting process. In the next video, I will be revealing my full plan to help you as a first time or beginner painter paint your pet in the comfort of your home and discover your joy in the painting process. So hopefully you've got some awesome photos already picked out and ready to start painting and ready to explore your creativity. So I will see you in the next video, and I hope you have a great day. Cheers.